What's up, guys? Levi Jaeckel here, back with another video. It's currently December 11th, and a lot of people are considering hiring a trainer. You might be looking to hire a trainer for a loved one for Christmas, or you might be thinking about starting up with that New Year's resolution game. Now, I understand I might be a little bit biased, but I truly do believe that hiring a good quality trainer that fits you might be one of the best investments that you can make. That being said, finding the right fit is a huge part of the process. For the sake of this video, I'm going to assume that you have some type of context on the trainer or the company that you're already interested in. Either you've been referred to them personally by one of their clients, or you've been following them online. You know, maybe you picked up a piece of their content on Instagram or YouTube or Facebook, and it kind of intrigued you to reach out a little further. So I'm going to assume that you've got a baseline idea of what they offer. And here are some questions that kind of peel back the layers on not only what, you know, the details of what they do, but then also to kind of eliminate maybe some not so great trainers. The first question that I think you should ask every trainer is, what is your training methodology? And that's a term that we use in the training industry. Basically, your training methodology is kind of your core training principles. What are the one or two or three things that you believe in that kind of are the backbone for your training? If someone were to ask me what my training methodologies were, I would tell them very briefly that my roots are in performance training. Working with athletes is kind of how I came up in this industry. So athletes need to be strong, mobile, well-conditioned, and resistant to injury. So all of my training has that flavor to it. This works well to prepare an athlete for a successful season, but it also works really well to prepare adults for a very long and healthy life. You want to make sure that when you ask them that question, that their values line up with what you're looking for. If longevity and general health and, you know, feeling good is what matters to you, you don't necessarily want to hire a trainer that only cares about how big your deadlift is or how many kipping pull-ups you can do in 4 minutes. That's kind of like just a basic question to make sure that right out of the gate, you guys are on the same page. The second question that I would ask them is, have you ever worked with a client that's in a position similar to my own? So again, you're just making sure that they understand kind of who you are and what you're looking for, and that they've got experience working with people in that sector. So for example, if a professional pitcher with a history of shoulder injuries were to ask me if I've ever worked with an athlete in a similar position to him, I would be able to say yes. On the flip side, if a client came to me and needed to lose 180 pounds in 360 days, I've never done that before. And if someone were to ask me that question, I would need to be very honest about that. That's not to say that that trainer isn't good for you, but I think that it is important to have that conversation up front. Trainers are very creative, and you know, some trainers can do very well outside of their normal training population, but you want to make sure that you might be an outlier in their current clientele right from the beginning. Kind of a follow-up question to that question is, if they have worked with people that have been in a similar position to you, I don't think that it's out of bounds to ask if you could email that former client. You know, have you ever worked with somebody in my position? And if they say yes, then I think that it's fair if you ask them, is it okay if I reach out to that client via email and ask them how their training experience was? For me personally, if somebody was to ask me that, you know, if they were to ask if they could connect with one of my current clients or a former client about their training experience, that would be the best thing that I could do. I would much rather refer them to a client and have that client tell them about that experience. First of all, it relieves me of a sales pitch of any kind. But second, I think that a second hand and an unbiased opinion is very powerful. Another question that I would ask them is, what is your evaluation process? Again, you want to know going into that experience what to expect right out of the gate. Typically, an evaluation is the very first thing you do. So you're getting a feel for what to expect right from day one. But it also does make sure that they've got their evaluation process locked in. All the great trainers that I know have a very thorough evaluation process. And as a prospective client, if I'm reaching out to that trainer, hearing about that evaluation process is going to make me feel very good about going to them. The very natural follow-up question to that is, okay, great, your evaluation process sounds awesome. How will you track my progress? Again, all the great trainers that I know have unbelievable programming systems. They plan your training sessions in advance and they track them along the way. Your progress along the way then influences the next training phase or the next couple weeks. If you're looking to hire a trainer, you want to make sure that they have good tracking systems. And then the final question that I would ask them is, what does your client exit process look like? That's kind of a weird question, but I do think that it's important. For example, if you're looking for a trainer to train with for 3 months because you have a birthday party that you want to look good for, you want to make sure that when that event does arrive, you have a good understanding on how you're going to stop training with them. You don't want to get to your birthday party and realize that you've been locked into a 6-month contract, or that maybe you have 10 extra sessions left in your package, or something similar like that. You know, when it's time for us to stop working together, what does that process look like? You want to make sure that it's smooth, that they have a plan, and that you're on board with that plan. All right, guys, hopefully these questions help you find a great trainer in your area. As always, if you have any questions for me or comments, please put them below. Thanks for hanging out for a little while, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Peace.